Section 4. Debugging and testing user interfaces. In this section, we will look at the tools that are available for debugging and testing user interfaces of desktop and web applications. First, we will connect Visual Studio to a running application to inspect and modify properties of individual user interface elements. We will continue with user interface tests, first for desktop applications, then for web applications. In the end, we will mention some of the challenges when running such tests unattended on a build server. Inspecting user interfaces at runtime. In this video, we will use Visual Studio to inspect user interfaces of running web and desktop applications. We will discuss what are the benefits of runtime user interface inspection over design time tooling. We will use browser link to establish a connection between Visual Studio and the running web application in a browser. We will use Live Visual Tree and Live Property Explorer windows in Visual Studio to explore a running XAML-based desktop application. In an ASP.NET MVC web application, we see the pages at design time as HTML, with extra eraser markup. Even with HTML knowledge, we can only see the structure of the page as the final appearance is mostly determined by the cascading style sheets. Of course, we can take a look at the CSS file where a specific class is defined and check the properties it sets. But imagining the final page appearance based on that is really difficult for most of us. If that wasn't enough, there's also the layout file, which specifies the basic common layout for all the pages. With all these factors contributing to the final appearance of the page, the only way to actually see how it will look in the end is to run the application and open the page in the browser. Here we can see how the page is actually rendered, but we still need to match individual rendered elements to their source. There are tools in the browser which can help us with that. For example, this is the element with the Jumbotron class which we were previously looking at in the source. And here are the computed CSS properties that are applied. While we could do changes directly in the browser, we will have to implement them in the source code as well in order to persist them. There is a tool in Visual Studio that can help us with that. It's called Browser Link. We can enable it from the Browser Link dropdown. We can also open the Browser Link dashboard to track its state. It seems that no browser is connected yet. For the feature to work, we need to restart the application. Now the browser is connected. We can now trigger browser refresh from Visual Studio. It would work even if we had more browsers connected. Also, any changes to CSS files will automatically be synced to the browser. To take full advantage of Browser Link, we need to install the Browser Link Inspector extension in Visual Studio. And we need to use Chrome instead of Edge. Also, we need to have the Web Essentials extension installed in Chrome. This adds a Visual Studio button to the toolbar, with two options. With Inspect mode, we can select an element in Chrome, and it will get selected in Visual Studio as well. Design mode works similarly, but also turns on editing. Any changes we do are automatically applied to source code as well. All these tools together can make editing of web pages in our application much easier. For desktop apps, Live Visual Tree provides a similar functionality to Browser Link for the web applications. To give it a try, we will run a simple universal Windows app. When built with the debug configuration, the application features a XAML inspection toolbar below the title bar. The first icon in the toolbar will open the Live Visual Tree window in Visual Studio. Inside it, we can explore the Visual Tree of our running application. Here, we can see the three pairs of text blocks and text boxes that our application is composed of. In a simple application like ours, it's easy to identify each individual component, but in more complex applications, this can become much more of a challenge. That's why there are additional tools available. The second icon in the toolbar enables selection mode, which allows us to select a component by clicking it in the application. The last icon turns on tracking of the focused element. As I now change the focus with the tab key, the selected node in the visual tree changes accordingly. The toolbar with the same icons is also present in the live visual tree window itself. Only the first icon is different. It can be used to hide the toolbar in the application. There are some additional functionalities available here as well. Preview selection helps us locate a component in the source code. When I now select a node, the source file will open with the matching element selected. The properties icon opens the live property explorer window. Here, I can see the properties of the selected element and also change them. In this video, we have tried out the Visual Studio tools for debugging user interfaces.